Okay, recording is started. We will start the session also. Okay, let me scroll through now. There are 49 students. Let me just scroll through all of you. I hope all of you are there in a stationary place, and then none of you are traveling. All of you are there with your notebook, pen, and even the calculator with you. So I think all of you had breakfast, so make sure that you are there attentive in the class. Okay, now let me just share the camera, and then okay, now camera has been shared. Oh, what happened? Okay, I think it's the sheet visible. Yeah, it is visible. Fine. So we'll continue with the thing. Let me just make it. So we'll actually try to understand three regions of operation. Let me just focus it again. It's not properly focused. Okay, better. Three regions of operation of a MOSFET are. Three regions of operation. One is cutoff, second one linear, third one saturation. Okay, let me take one student with me for next 10 minutes. Okay, I'll take Akshata. Akshata, can you come online?
Yes, sir.
Akshata, please mute.
Sir?
Is it fine now? Okay, now it's not again. Okay, now it's not again. I think you are on both laptop as well as mobile.
No, sir.
But I could able to hear that. You are on a loudspeaker.
Yes, sir.
Make sure that you have a earphone.
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Okay, by that time, okay. Hello?
Sir.
Yeah, fine.
Sir.
Now, these are the regions of operation of MOSFET, cutoff, linear, and saturation. So, when do we say it is cutoff? So, we have this, okay, VGS and VDS. Is it now? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Here it should be less than or equal to VTH, correct? Again, still that echo is there. Akshata?
Yes, sir, I have connected.
Hello?
Hello?
Still I can hear my voice back.
Sir, I have connected my earphone.
Okay, let me just... Ankita, can you come online? Akshata, you go off. Go off, matlab only go off from your... mute yourself. Akshata? Sorry. Ankita?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. So, for other two regions, okay, for linear and saturation, VGS should be greater than VTH. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, this is again should be VTH, should be more than VTH. So, how about VDS? For linear
VDS
region?
VDS should be less than VDS sat.
Perfect. And here it should be more than? VDS.
VDS part.
Perfect. Now, let us start the analysis. Suppose if I have something like this. And of course, before that, shall we write the expression for drain current at all the three regions? So, this is ID cutoff. Correct? Is it zero? Ankita?
Sir. Yes, sir.
No, under cutoff region, when the MOSFET is operating in cutoff region, what is the drain current? Because when there is no channel existing, there is no current between drain to source. So ID is equal to zero.
Sir.
Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is ID linear? Can we write it as half into KP W by L to VGS minus VTO into
VDS square.
I think it is 2 times VGS minus VTH into VDS minus VDS square. Correct? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how about ID in saturation region?
Half
Kp W by L into
VGS
minus VTH whole square.
Okay.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
These are the conditions, these are the voltages required to operate the MOSFET in 3 different regions, and these are the corresponding currents under different operating regions. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
ID side 1 by 2 should be cancelled.
Come where?
So in ID side 1 by 2 should not be there, I think.
It is there.
2 and 1 by 2.
It is there. Half into Kp W by L. Okay, let us just verify to clarify that. Let me just show that. Okay, what is the expression for? I think, is this visible? No, let me just share this also. Let us verify that. Okay, where is this? Okay, this is okay. Now, this is the expression for linear region. Perfect. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the expression for ID in linear region. Half, this is mu n into Cox is Kp into W bell, 2 into VGS minus VTH into VDS minus VDS square. Let us go for saturation. This is for saturation. ID is equal to half into Kp W by L VGS minus VTH whole square. Okay? This is what I have.
Yes.
Half into Kp W by L VGS minus VTH whole square. So let us not have any doubts in equations. Of course, no need to remember all these things. Remember, matlab, no need to by heart. So make sure that whether square is there or not. So that will come when you start understanding, okay, what is the unit of Kp, what is the unit of W, L, and all these things. So because on left hand side, right hand side, the unit should match. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, perfect. Okay, let us move on now. So, shall we consider this as a circuit diagram for something like, let me call it as VGG, let me call it as VDD. So, shall I call this as VDS here? Shall I write this as VGS? When I say VGS, this is plus, this is minus, measured across gate and source. This is measured across drain and source. This is plus and minus. Correct?
Okay.
Okay. Now, let us simulate this. So before simulating, so shall we define the dot model file? This is dot model NMOS. I'm supposed to write this same thing in your LTSpice. So let us take Kp is equal to 200 micro and VTO is equal to 0.4. For the entire AMCD class, let us assume the Kp for NMOS as 200 micron. This is the magnitude. Unit is ampere per volt square. What is the unit of Kp? Ampere per volt square. The unit of VTO or VTH is volt. No need to write it as, so in the model file, don't write it as ampere per volt square. Don't write this. Just write the value of it. So it should be only 200 U. So for micro, which is nothing but mu, in your usual writing, but in LTSpice you can write it as U, small u or capital U, both are same. It is not case sensitive in, it is not case sensitive. Case sensitive. What is not case sensitive? LTSpice tool is not case sensitive. Whether you write small u or capital U, it is micro. Correct? For milli, it is small m or capital M, it is milli. For kilo, either small k or capital K, it is, because we'll be using these values, no? For kilo ohms, mega ohms, and giga hertz and all those things. For mega, you have to write it as MEG, either small MEG or capital MEG. This is mega. So this capital M doesn't mean that it is 10 power 6. It is still because usually when you, if you want to write 10 may go home, will you write it as something like this, Ankita?
Yes, sir.
But in LTSpice, if you want to have 10 mega ohm, you have to write 10 MEG or 10 MEG. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, these are all, I'm just trying to tell you, okay, what is this engineering parameter, that is, okay, micro, millis, and gigas, and picos, that the way how you should write. Done? So in the dot model file, we have to write dot model NMOS NMOS KP is equal to 200U and then VTO is equal to 0.4. So let us take up this example and then try to simulate. So let me take an example of one of the circuit what we practiced yesterday. Let us, as I said, let KP be 200 microampere per volt square. Ankita, is it visible? Is it blur,
no,
something
sir.
Like that? Is it not visible?
Lagging, sir. It's lagging.
Other than lagging, is the clarity fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, lagging I can't help out because it's a network issue. So at least is KP is equal to 200 microampere volt square even upon lagging, when it is stationary, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Now it's visible, no? Let me write VTO is equal to 0.4 volt. Done? Hello?
It's stuck, sir.
It is stuck. Maybe in your case, it's in which network you have? Is the network speed good?
Yes, sir.
Okay, done. So that is a network issue. Let us not too much worry about it. So do we have the circuit now? So let us take VGG is equal to 0.6 volt and this as 1.8 volt. Done?
Yes, sir.
Now let us take width of the transistor as 500 micrometer and length of the transistor as 100 micrometer. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So now let us try to find out what is with this as 0.6 and this as 1.8, what may be the operating region of this MOSFET? Is it on, is it in saturation, or is it in cutoff or linear region?
It's in on.
It's on, perfect. Then is it linear saturation?
Linear.
Why? How
because
VDS,
VDS is less than VDS sat.
How much is VDS sat?
Oh, sorry, saturation, sir.
How much is VDS? It's fine. Okay, what is VDS sat? How much? For this
0.1.
example, VDS sat is equal to VGS minus VTH. Am I correct? How much
yes,
is
sir.
VGS? 0.6. How much is VTH? 0.4. So this is 0.2, no? Am I correct? See here, we assume it as 0.4.
Yes, sir.
No, for these values.
Yes, sir.
So what is actual VDS?
0.2.
VDS?
1.8.
It's 1.8. So what is VDS and VDS sat relation? Greater than.
VDS. Yes, sir.
So it's in saturation.
Saturation.
What is the expected current now? Shall I write ID saturation is equal to half KP W by L VGS minus VTO whole square? Is it now 0.5 into 200 micro into 500 by 100 into 0.2 whole square?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, all of you calculate. Use your calcis. Make it fast. Let me also do it from my side. Point 0.5 into 200 exponential minus 6 into 5 into don't type it as 500 by 100, simply type it as 5 into 0.04. Is it 20 micro? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How much time you people take, SA? You are all youngsters, no? So when I can do so fast, okay, why not you people? So it is 20 micrometer. Sorry, 20 microampere. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Shall we just go back to simulator and then verify it? Let me just share that LTSpy screen. Where is my LTSpy? LTSpy, come on. It's here. Let me just take this new schematic. What all things I should add? Come on.
Width, length.
First, I need to add the MOSFET now. Yes. When you add MOSFET, then only you can think of width, length. Done? I'm just joking.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what else you need? Just see the components you require. You need to have two power supplies, correct?
Yes,
let
sir.
Me have a power supply here. This one here, let me name it as VDD itself, VDD, and then what can I name this as? VGG, because that's how we named it. So let
sir,
me.
It should be a number, right? V1 should be named as VGG.
That's what I'm doing, man. This is VGG. Oh, fine, perfect. Value. Okay, let me just make it as perfect. 0.6 is the value. Name should be VGG. So I actually changed the value to VGG. Perfect. This is VGG. All of you got it. Now what? Who said it? 1.8. Somebody said, okay, it should be so and so. Okay, now let me make this VDD. Done? Because value cannot be a number. So sorry, value cannot be what? Something like name. So value should be a numeric. Now let me just, okay, all these are done. Let me make the connection. What are the shortcut key for making connection?
F3.
Perfect.
Function F3.
F3 or function F3 depending on your system. Laptop. Because in some of the laptops, if you want to activate F3, you may have to press function. Otherwise, okay, let me just make sure that it is done. Okay, now it's fine. All of you are there with me? I hope all of you are there with me. Of course, today at 5:30, you're going to have a quiz. Quiz of I don't know how many questions. It will be for half an hour, not more than 1 minute per question. Maybe half an hour or 20 minutes. You're going to have 20 questions. It will be all MCQs. No need to too much worry about the hard studies. So if you're attentive in the class, you can very comfortably answer the questions. So be ready for that. And it will be counted. Okay, each and every effort that you have put in will going to certainly fetch you some points in the entire continuous evaluation. Okay, let me also do. Don't worry too much. Dot model NMOS. Again, NMOS. Open the parenthesis. KP is equal to 200U, comma. VTO is equal to 0.4. Close the parenthesis. It's done. This is my model file. Done? Akshita,
yes.
Sorry, Ankita, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is missing in the circuit? Ground.
Ground.
Perfect. So let me connect the ground. How do I connect the ground? Function F3 or F3 do. Done. Shall I do dot OP? Dot OP is enough. What does dot op will give you?
Only
the values of the output, sir.
What output you are looking for? It gives all DC operating voltage and current, sir. Correct. Is it?
Yes, sir.
So what is one thing that we have missed out? We didn't put the dimensions. So let us put the dimension as 100U and then tab 500U. So are we done with everything now? So we are expecting how much current? We are expecting a current of how much? 20 microampere, correct?
Yes, sir.
So let us see whether it is 20 milliampere or something different. So let me just see. Where I can do the edit simulation command. So I can do dot op. done, this is there. So all of you should place this. Okay, whenever you do the simulation, you need to place this dot op thing. Now you can run. Oh, perfect. Can you see here? The current is. Can you see the current there? ID of
yes,
M1,
sir.
2 into
yes,
10
sir.
Power minus 5, which is nothing but 20 micro.
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
Yes, sir.
So now, suppose if I change this voltage to, okay, let me just go back to my screen here. How do I make this MOSFET to go to saturation region? Sorry, linear region. So what I'll do?
By
okay, Akshar, okay, Ankita, no? Ankita, what I'll
yes,
do?
Sir.
I'll put a resistor here. Fine.
Yes,
I'll put
sir.
A resistor of 1 kilo ohm. Done.
Yes, sir.
So now, if I put a resistor of 1 kilo ohm, can you write a KVL for this? Kirchhoff voltage law, loop equation for this? So, what does, let me just rewrite that circuit. Of course, now the heat or the real AMCD stuff will start, or the circuit stuff will start from today. So far, it was pretty easy. I'm not saying that it is difficult. Now, it is more involved. Now you need to understand so many concepts, you need to recollect so many things and all those things. So now,
sir, I think screen recording is not on.
It is on, madam. It's turned on. It's happening. It's
okay.
Happening. I'm doing it in a different one. So I'm doing it in OBS. It's not in what is that? Your which one? Cisco Webex. It's in a different platform. How do you get to know? Okay, it's not on.
We get symbol here, sir.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay. I think earlier also you are not getting the symbol. Okay, now this is VDD, this is VGG, this is 0.6, this is 1.8. Let us have this as resistor name R1 with the value is equal to 1 kilo ohm. So this is the usual circuit. Now, shall I write, okay, shall I write this as plus minus VDS? This is why I call it as VDS is it is the voltage between drain and source. Is this the drain point?
Yes, sir.
Is this a source? The
yes,
voltage
sir.
Across drain and source, shall I write it as VDS?
Yes, sir.
So now I'll write this as capital VDD. So shall I write applied capital VDD is equal to, do we have a current of ID here? ID
yes,
into R1 plus VDS. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Is this my KVL equation? Applied voltage is equal to this drop plus this drop. Convinced?
Yes, sir.
Or is there any other way of, okay, what you can do is, suppose if you start moving from here, suppose if you take voltage rise as negative, it is minus VDD. And if you take, now you can see this is minus to plus, no? I will take voltage
yes,
rise as negative. This is plus to minus. Is this voltage drop here?
Yes, sir.
This is voltage drop. If you are assumed a negative sign for voltage rise, it will be plus for voltage drop. Is it ID into RD? Sorry, ID into R1? Can you
yes,
see
sir.
One more voltage drop? Plus into, okay, plus VDS. Complete voltage rise and two voltage drops?
Yes, sir.
So, can I rewrite this expression as this one?
Yes, sir.
So, that's what I'm written. So, applied voltage, what does your KVL say? It says applied voltage is equal to drop across the other elements in the loop.
Yes.
Done?
Yes, sir.
Now, Let us take the circuit now. So let us take the situation what we have now. Where I have the sheet. Let me take one more sheet. Okay, done. So I have, what is the current that we have for this corresponding thing? 20 microampere, no?
20 micro, yes sir.
So this is ID. How much is R1 we are considering? 1 kilo ohm.
1 kilo ohm.
What is VDD is equal to? It is ID into R1. Plus VDS. Am I correct?
Yes,
but
sir.
I know this. I know this. I know this. I can find this. So shall I rewrite this as VDS is equal to VDD minus ID into R1? Because I want to know
yes,
what
sir.
Is VDS. Because this is given by you as 1.8. You know the current as 20 microampere. You know the resistance as 1 kilo ohm. So can I know what is VDS now? Is it 1.8
yes,
minus 20 micro into 1K?
Yes,
am I
sir.
Correct? So what is this now?
Yes,
use the calci. Come.
20 milli.
Sir, 1.78.
So this is what is VDS. Is the MOSFET in saturation region or linear region? Okay, let me just go back to circuit. Is the circuit visible to all of you? It is. Is it fine? Now what I'll do, I'll insert a resistor. How do I insert a resistor? Simply type R, you'll get a resistor. Control R, rotate, and then place it here. It will get inserted. I'll make this resistance as 1K. Done?
Yes, sir.
Now let me run. What I'll do, I'll run it. See, the current is still so and so. Can you see here? Current is 2 into 10 power minus 5. Can you see
yes,
V of N1? V of N1 is 1.78. Or let me name
yes,
this
sir.
Node as VD. What I'll do, I'll just name this node as what is that? F4. Shall I name it as VD? VD is nothing but, or let me call it as VDS itself. VDS. I'll just name this here so that you can understand okay what is VDS is. Done? Let me run.
Yes,
F. Okay, there is no shortcut. Okay. Can you see what is VDS?
Yes, sir.
1.78. Is it the same as we calculated here?
Yes, sir.
Now, what I'll do, I'll increase the resistance value to 10K. What I'll do, I'll go back here, increase it to 10K. I'll just stop this. I'll make it 10K. What will happen now? Okay, let us go back to my screen. If I make this instead of 1K, if I make it 10K, what will be the VDS? 1.8 minus 20 micro into 10K. Am I correct?
Yes,
sir. Will it become 1.6 volt?
Yes, sir.
Is the MOSFET in saturation?
Yes, sir.
Let us make it 10K. Let me run it. See here it is 1.6. Can you see VDS is 1.6? Hello?
Sir.
Is it 1.6?
Yes, sir.
VDS.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, what is the minimum voltage of VDS to keep this MOSFET in saturation? For this particular case. See here, you have VTO as 0.4. Ankita?
Yes, sir.
VGS as 0.6.
Yes, sir.
What is the minimum VDS required to keep the MOSFET in saturation?
VGS minus VTH.
That is?
VDS that.
So?
0.2.
Correct. So, VDS minimum. Okay, let me show your VDS minimum. To keep M1 in saturation is VDS sat. Correct? How
yes,
much
sir.
Is that in this case? So
0.2.
VDS minimum should be 0.2 volt, that is 200 millivolt. Correct?
Yes,
now,
sir.
by increasing what value, suppose, assume that if I'm keep on increasing this resistance. So what I'll do, you have this VDS is equal to VDD minus ID into R1, no? Correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If I increase this resistance, does this reduce?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Because value will decrease.
This will
minus.
Go into the amount of subtraction from a constant value is keep on reducing. Means, okay, the resultant will reduce. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
the VDS will reduce if I increase R1.
Yes, sir.
Y means if you take this circuit, if you take this circuit, can you see if I increase this resistance, out of this 1.8, more will drop here, less is available.
Yes, sir.
Because if you have 100 rupees, if you keep on spending money, so will you be left out with more amount? It will keep on reducing, no? It is like spending. So you are actually dropping it here. The amount that is available across drain to source is less and less. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Shall we find out for what value of R the MOSFET enters the linear region? Shall I find R1 max to keep MOSFET at verge of saturation? Verge of saturation. It's not difficult. Now I want to find that maximum value of R which keeps the MOSFET at verge of saturation. What do you mean by verge of saturation?
Starting to
where
saturation.
VDS is 200 millivolt. Correct? If the value
yes,
of VDS becomes 200 millivolt, then you are at the verge. So suppose if I want to say something like this, suppose if you say this is your characteristics. So this is, assume that this is VDS sat. Assume that this is VDS sat. Correct? Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, it's visible. Fine. Assume that this is VDS sat. Now,
yes, sir.
If this is 200 millivolt, if this value is 200 millivolt, any voltage, okay, this is actually VDS. This is VDS. If VDS is more than 200 millivolt, it is in saturation. If it is less than 200 millivolt, it is in linear region. The verge is this point. Verge is this point, 200 millivolt. So that's what I'm trying to say. If you keep on increasing the value of R1, is this value keep on reducing?
Yes, sir.
So we are trying to find that value of maximum value of R to keep the MOSFET at the verge of saturation. If the value of R1 is more than that, it comes to linear region. If the value of R is less than that, it will be there in saturation region. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So we'll just do that. What I'll do, I'll take. So what you have, VDS is equal to VDD minus ID into R1. No? Correct?
Yes, sir.
What you are interested in? You are interested in R1 max. See here. Let me just redo it. VDS is equal to VDD minus ID into R1 max. The moment you write R1 max, this will be VDS minimum. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, shall I, do you know what is VDS minimum?
0.2.
So 0.2 is equal to 1.8 minus 20 micro into R1 max. Can I rewrite this expression instead of writing this? Can I write R1 max as equal to VDD, correct? VDD
yes,
minus VDS minimum by ID?
Yes, sir.
So what is this now? 1.8 minus 0.2 by 20 micro. Give me. 1.6 by 20. Is it 80K? Sorry.
80 milli.
80 micro, ma'am. 80 mega. Or 80 mega or what? 80K.
80K.
80 kilo ohms. So it is 1.6 divided by 20 exponential minus 3, it is 80K. Now, if I go back to this circuit, if I make it equal to 80 kilo ohm, if I run it, what is expected VDS? What is expected VDS? How much VDS you'll get? Because you are putting the maximum value of R1 to keep the MOSFET at verge of saturation. if you see the value of VDS, it will be how much?
0.2.
So let me just show that. See, now I made it 80k. So I will run it. You can see that is, can you see here? VDS is 0.2.
Yes, sir.
So the entire meaning of this is, by changing this value, suppose if the value of R is something like, okay, you can see the current is still 20 micro, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, yes, sir. If I make it 85K, what will happen?
Saturation.
Hey, just see. Suppose if it is, because you said, or we just calculated, the maximum value of resistance to keep the MOSFET at the verge of saturation is 80K. If you keep it more than 80K, it will go out of saturation, no? It will go into linear region. See, it is now 85K. See now, what was happening here? Suppose this is 1.8. This is 1.8, no?
Yes.
If this is 80K, 0.2 is left out here, VDS. How much is dropping here if it is 80K? How much is dropping across this? Let me just go back here. So, VDD is 1.8, correct? If
yes, sir.
RD is 80K, how much is ID into, this is R1. How much is ID into R1? 1.6 volt. How much is VDS? 0.2. Correct?
Yes, sir.
This is 1.8. If it is 70K, how much is ID into R1? Is it 1.4 volt?
Yes, sir.
Then how much is this? How much is this? This minus this, 0.4. What is VDS? VDS is VDD minus ID into R1.
Yes, sir.
So this is again 1.8. If you make it 85K, what is this drop? See here, this, what is this value? Okay, let me also write ID. So this is 20 micro. This is 20 micro. Why it is 20 micro? Why it is 20 micro? Because MOSFET is still in saturation.
Yes, sir.
If I make it 85K, let me just show you what happens. If I make it 85K and run, interestingly, you can see current has reduced. It is no more 20 micro, it has reduced because MOSFET has entered the linear region and VDS is less than 0.2. This is very critical. Sir. If you people can understand this much, then 90% of the AMCD is done. See here, let me just clarify this. When the resistance is more than 85K, the VDS has reduced less than so and so. Can you see the current is also less than 20? This was 20 micro. Does the current reduce?
Yes,
when the current reduced,
yes,
why the current is reduced? Because VDS has reduced less than 200 micro. So MOSFET is operating in linear region. Whatever 20 micro is not valid because the expression for ID linear is different compared to ID saturation. Correct?
Yes,
why
sir.
why the current is not 20 micro? Because VDS is less than VDS sat. How do we verify this current expression, current value? You have to substitute that in the other current equation. So you have other current equation, no? What the other current equation? You have this equation. Where is that? I don't know. Here. If I substitute to this particular equation, linear, you'll get it. So you know what is this Kp, Wbell, VGS, you know, VTH, you know what is VDS. What is VDS now? VDS is actually this value. 0.16, that is 161 millivolts. If you substitute 161 millivolt in this expression, you will get whatever current that you're getting, it has 19 point something milliampere. Sorry, microampere. Okay, we will discuss all these things. I just want to show you that how do you make the MOSFET to enter from saturation to linear region by changing the resistance values. I think we can go to next class now. I think next class is mathematics. Thank you so much for
Excuse
joining.
Me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah. Come.
Sir, I am not getting mail, sir.
Okay, you'll get your mail. I have not added you. This is Vinut, no?
So no, sir, Vilas.
Vilas, okay. Okay, done.
Sir, WebEx meeting mail also I am not getting, even module some mails will get, so that
Moodle,
also
Moodle,
not getting, or
Moodle.
SAT.
Okay, WebEx you can somehow get it. Moodle, of course, you should get it so that you can able to submit the assignments, all those things. This is Vilas, no? Just message me what's
yes,
your
sir.
USN and SIT mail ID, I'll do that.
Even WebEx meeting ID, that mail also I know.
Yeah, yeah, that is for the entire month, it is same mail. Okay then, fine. So thank you so much for
thank
joining.
You.
So then I'll be stopping.